Hello, welcome back to the Jolly's Kitchen. Today I'm doing a bit of escovitch fish. I'm using white fish, which I have defrosted and seasoned, obviously washed with your lime and whatever you need to wash your fish or your meat with. And I just season it with some black pepper, I use a veggie seasoning, the Oxo veggie seasoning, because I believe it has less salt and it flavors it really nice. So I have a little bit of cayenne pepper, black pepper, and the veggie seasoning, and a little bit of salt, and I mix that all together and just season the fish and leave it to rest for a while. And then in here, I have a little bit of self-raising flour with some cornstarch just to give a little extra crispiness to it. Don't want it too floury, just slightly to hold the fish because the fish are a bit soft. So that's what that's for. And here I have I use my slicer and I sliced up some veg. I have some sweet peppers, some thyme, some onions, some carrots, and some garlic. And I have various colors of sweet pepper in there. And then here I have a little bit of the seasoning that's left when I'm ready to cook up all this carrots and what you call them veg. Then I'll use a little bit of that with a little bit of oil from frying and then make it into a Jolly style escovitch fish. I'll take you along. Catch you in the next session. Okay, now I'm starting the second phase. So what I'm gonna do, the oil is on the fire, it's hot, and I put a little bit extra oil in there because I want the fish to be able to sit nicely in the oil. I'm putting in half of onion. I leave the skin off on two cloves of garlic. I leave the skin on because I don't want them to burn. As such, I just want them to give a little extra flavor to the fish. So now I'm going to. Sorry, I'm filming while I'm doing this, so forgive me. And I'm using like one hand. So I'm just going to give you an idea of what I do. So I take the fish, I drop it in the flour, press it down a little bit. Turn it over, press it down a little bit. Just want to get it like covered, slightly covered. I don't want it too heavy. Shake off the excess and then in the oil. So basically, that's what I'm doing. I'm flouring the fish lightly, then I'm putting it in the frying pan, and I'm going to repeat this process until it's all done. So I'll catch you back in a little bit to show you what it looks like when I finish frying them the most. Okay, here we go. We have one piece left in there doing its thing. I have the veg on here ready, and here's just a few pieces. I'm doing 5 pieces today because only two of us, so we don't cook a whole lot of food. So here we have 4 pieces and just one left to go. So just gonna crack it a little bit. Okay, so in here I'm gonna put a little bit of vinegar. Yeah, so in here I'm gonna put a little bit of vinegar, a little bit of seasoning that's left. Remember I told you. And some of the oil from here. I'm gonna add it to there and just let it steam a bit. And then after which I'll add it to the fish so it'll be nice and tasty. Hopefully. I'll see you in the next part. Okay, so this is what this part looks like. Does have a mixture of vinegar, some of the oil that I used to fry the fish, and I put a little bit of sugar in there to counteract, to kind of cut the sharpness of the vinegar, so it'll bring all the taste together and stuff. So that's what it looks like. That's what the fish looks like. And I'll show you when I'm at the finishing part of it. Okay. Okay, here we go. I don't want it to cook too soft. I want it to have a bite. So I'll give it a few more minutes. I didn't give you amounts to put in there because it depends on the amount that you're doing and what you like to taste, how you like it to taste. So I just put a little bit of this and a little bit of that according to how I like it. So obviously you have to clean up after the fish. So I'm in the process of that now, washing up everything, because you know, when you cook fish, it still leaves the scent after you finish, and I hate it. So I am just doing a little bit of tidying up in the meantime, and then I catch back with you when it's all done and I'm combining the whole thing. All right? So welcome back. I am ready to combine my veg to the fish. So just bear in mind, I'm filming this all by myself, so I have to pay attention to I probably did a little bit more veg than I need to, because I only have like 5 small pieces. Okay. And then I'm going to get a little bit of sauce. Sorry, and a little bit of sauce, so it's, yeah, I can just like throw it on like that. Okay, I think that's enough. So I have a bit left over. I can freeze that and use it for something else. I was saying, in the meantime, while I was waiting on this to be completed, I was tidying up. I like my kitchen like really tidy, so okay. It smells good, also. So I'll let you know how it tastes when we're ready to eat. Don't know what we're having this with yet, but I'll let you know. All right, bye. So here we have the finished product. Mr. Jolly is doing the taste test for me, and he's gonna tell me how it tastes. Fingers crossed. How is it, Mr. Jolly? Is it good? Well, there you go, with the Jolly's scavenge fish at home cooking style. It's a real people thing.
Don't know where we're gonna fly like you did.